So today we're going to start off with one of the most important and a difficult chapter of your book, that is The Long Walk to Freedom. This is an extract from the autobiography of Nelson Mandela. We all know Nelson Mandela as a freedom fighter, as a person who stood up for the rights of the South Africans. He went to jail for the longest period of time because he wanted equality. Now, before I start with this chapter, let us just discuss a few things. What is apartheid? Are you aware of this term? Are you aware of this term? What does it mean? It is discrimination on the basis of color, basis of the race you belong to. Yes. Why do you think people behave like this? Why do you think people behave like this? Yes. So what's wrong with their minds, Karthik? Why do they behave like this? They do not realize that all people are equal. Yeah. And do you think it is, you know, like good to decide who is superior and who is inferior based on your race that you belong to or on the basis of the color of your skin? Is it a good thing? It's not. And how was this policy followed? You know, when we talk about here this discrimination, there was also separation. There was a segregation also. There were certain places where the people could not go, which were out of bound for them, right? They could not go to the same places, even on traveling of buses also there. Yes, so the people there, right, the white people or the Britishers and the other people, they enjoyed, yes, more benefits than the South African original people. Okay. Yes, there were many wars. There were many, you can say, rebellions which took place. There were leaders who raised their voices. Many of them lost their lives. Many of them went to jail. Right. And we are going to read here in this chapter when Nelson Mandela became the president of South Africa and how he felt that getting that equality. What are the ways, other ways in which people are treated unequally? They're not given equal importance. They're made to feel that you are inferior. The caste system, Karthik, very good, right? What other inequalities exist in our society? What are the other inequalities that exist? Gender inequality, very correct. So how can we change all this? How can we change all this? We talk about female feticide. We talk about inequality. Yes, that social inequality, economic inequality, all these things are there. We need to create awareness. We need to create awareness. And some things, yes, we have to start at home ourselves only. Right? When we look around the world here, we still have people discussing about, you know, like as I discussed earlier, we had about Black Lives Matter. Yes. Big episode, like incident that happened last year and yes, getting justice. We still have people who discriminate on the basis of caste. We have people there discriminating on the basis of appearance. So why are we not ready to accept people who are different from us? What is it that is wrong with us? What is there then? There's something wrong with us only. Why we don't understand that, yes, all humans are equal. So we have to change our mindset. We have to change our thinking. We have to understand that each and everyone is born equal and they deserve to be treated equally, right? So social inequality that we talk about, gender discrimination here, we are there, you know, like immediately when you have someone who is not very well off, is not as rich as you are, or is not as wealthy as you are, your behavior changes. When you see someone who is not physically healthy, you see someone who is handicapped, disabled, our behavior changes, right? When you talk about opportunities, when you talk about, you know, like, yes, moving forward. So when it comes to discriminating between a girl and a boy, then also our thinking it changes, right? So there are so many things here that need to change. And apartheid here, it was maybe one of the biggest injustice which happened against the human beings here, right? That is the discrimination on the basis of the color of their skin, the race they belong to. One race considering that they are superior than the other. Took a lot of struggle, took a lot of, you can say, sacrifices to attain that freedom, to attain that equality. Some things have changed. Some things have not changed. We still have a long way to go in our society when we start considering everyone as equal, right? So we'll come to that also. We'll be discussing it in more detail. First of all, let's just have a look at the chapter. Okay. Yes, so we have here that what is apartheid? It's a political system that separates people according to their race. Can you say which of these three countries named below had such a political system until very recently, according to their race? So it was very predominant in South Africa. Otherwise also, yes, we had, have you heard about slavery? Have you heard about slavery? Yes. So slavery was also there. And when we talk about America, and other places here. So there was a civil war. There was this declaration of independence, abolishing slavery. So many injustices have happened. But one thing is there, thank God that human beings are able to realize their mistake and they are able to, you know, like, yes, raise a voice against such injustice. Have you heard of Nelson Mandela and his African National Conference? Spent a lifetime fighting against apartheid. Mandela had to spend 30 years in prison. Finally, democratic elections were held in South Africa in 1994, and Mandela became the first Black president of a new nation. Black president of a new nation. So to get that rights in their own country, to be equal in their own country, they had to fight a lot. So strange. In this extract from his autobiography, Long Walk to Freedom, Mandela speaks about a historic occasion, the inauguration. So it's an inauguration. Yes, so you can check here, it's 10th May 1994. What is the inauguration? The inauguration is the beginning of a new government, beginning of new changes, beginning of a new policy, right? And it is here about, so we'll discuss these vocabulary words when we have read the chapter. This chapter deals with the swearing-in ceremony of Nelson Mandela, became the first Black president of South Africa after apartheid, which is a policy of racial discrimination on the basis of the race that you belong to. And here it was predominantly, yes, because of the color of their skin, right? So here that separation there happening and now getting freedom, a very important historic occasion. And Nelson Mandela is there addressing the people and thinking about the sacrifices. 10th May dawned bright and clear. For the past few days, I had been pleasantly besieged by dignitaries and world leaders who were coming to pay their respects before the inauguration. The inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leaders on South African soil. After a long, long time, so many leaders were coming to be a part of this important occasion. And they were coming here to show their support to this new government. They were coming here to show that, yes, we agree that all that inequality and injustice has been removed, and they are ready to acknowledge the new government that has been formed. Okay. The ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Buildings in Pretoria. So where did the ceremony take place? In an amphitheater. Amphitheater, just like you have your stadiums nowadays, right? You watch where all these IPL matches take place. So that there, the amphitheater. Sandstone, it's a kind of a stone, right? From which that amphitheater was made. The building blocks there, okay? That was the amphitheater made of sandstone. For decades, this had been the seat of white supremacy. So this area here, this had been the area of white supremacy. Supremacy means superiority. And now it was the site of a rainbow gathering of different colors and nations for the installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. See here. First of all, which color was dominant over there? White supremacy. Who all were they heading the country? Who all were they heading the government? The white people. But now, at the time, what do you think is the significance of this line? The site of a rainbow gathering of different colors. Rainbow gathering of different colors. What is the contrast here? पहले कौन डोमिनेट कर रहा था? Yes, the white people. And now what is there? There is so many colors, there are so many races all coming together. And they are all supporting South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. Okay, is this clear? So see how things change if you have the courage to bring about a change, if you have the courage to raise your voice against injustice. So here, where the white people were there, now there are people of so many colors and so many races. They're all coming together to support the new government. On that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Zenani. Autumn, what was the date? Can you tell me what was the date here? What was the date of the inauguration? Look at the first line. 10th May. Yes, Amritpal, very nice. And now what is he talking about the season there? Which season should be there in May? Which season should be there? Summer. Then why is he saying autumn? On that lovely autumn day. Yes. Why is it so? Why is it so? Because of the different hemispheres, isn't it? Yes, we talk about South Africa there. On that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Zenani. On the podium, Mr. de Klerk was first sworn in as second deputy president. So there were other officials who were sworn in, who were taking the oath before him. Then Thabo Mbeki was sworn in as first deputy president. When it was my turn, I pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people. To the assembled guests and the watching world, I said, now this is a part of his speech. This is Nelson Mandela. And what was the speech that he gave? All of you, please listen carefully, read carefully, write the meaning on your book if you have to, and please be attentive. Today, all of us do, by our presence here, confer glory and hope to newborn liberty. So we are here, you are present, and together we are conferring, you know, we are granting this glory to a newborn liberty. What does liberty mean? Yes, what does liberty mean? Liberty means freedom. Freedom from inequality, freedom from the racial discrimination, apartheid. Out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster that lasted too long, must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud. Extraordinary human disaster. This disaster that happened, it was man-made. This discrimination that took place, it was man-made. And now from this discrimination, what has risen? A new government, a new society, and humanity will be proud of them. So they cannot be declared as inferior because of the color or because of the race. We who were outlaws not so long ago have today been given the rare privilege to be host to the nations of the world on our own soil. Outlaw. Jisko bahar nikal diya gaya. Right? That is an outlaw, isn't it? Right? Someone was not accepted by the law. And why was this happening? Many countries did not show their support to the government of South Africa. The Britishers who were there, the white people who were there, right? But now, since apartheid had been abolished, and now there's a new government, all the people, all the leaders across the world are showing their support, right? We thank all of our distinguished international guests for having come to take possession with the people of our country of what is, after all, a common victory for justice, for peace, for human dignity. So he's thanking everyone who's come there to be a part of this important occasion. We have at last achieved our political emancipation. Political freedom they have got. How is it that they've got political freedom? They'll be able to form their own government. We pledge ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty, deprivation, suffering, gender, and other discrimination. See how beautifully he's saying that we will pledge, we promise that we will liberate our people here from this bond of poverty, deprivation, right? They're not having their proper benefits. Suffering here, gender discrimination. Never, never, and never again shall it be that this beautiful land will again experience the oppression of one by another. The sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Let freedom reign. God bless Africa. So here, yes, Nelson Mandela is given his speech, and he's talking about the freedom of the people. He's talking about the responsibility of the new government, and he wants that such a situation should not happen ever again. That once they have got this freedom, and they should work hard for equality. Equality in every sphere, okay? Right? So whether it is political liberation they have got, removing gender discrimination, they should make sure that nobody is deprived of anything. So they should have all the benefits. Okay. Now let's just quickly go through these comprehension questions. So where did the ceremony take place? Yes. Where did the ceremony take place? In the... Yeah, come on, raise your hands and give me the answers. Where did the ceremony take place? It took place in the sandstone amphitheater, right? In Pretoria. Yes, the amphitheater. Okay. So, Justine is writing a very nice spelling of that. Can you say how 10th May is an autumn day? How is it an autumn day? We've just discussed because of the geographical differences. That is why, yes, the hemispheric. Yeah, Amritpal, very nice. And right, it is there. It can also be said that it is an important day because of the significance of this day. Yes, Genevieve says it's a red letter day. Okay, So here it is. Yeah, it is an important day when all the leaders have come together and they are witnessing this big change, the change of government, the change of leadership, right? So that way, so both you can write down here, main would be, yes, that it here, that it is a coming together of so many people and that rainbow gathering that he talks of. At the beginning of his speech, Mandela mentions an extraordinary human disaster. What does he mean by this? What is the extraordinary human disaster that he refers to? What is extraordinary human? It is racial discrimination, but was apartheid that he refers to. And what is the glorious human achievement he speaks of at the end? The glorious human achievement, achieving equality, achieving recognition, removing that inequality. And yes, being able to form a government of their own. Yes, that he got equality. Very right. Now, why does he thank the international leaders? Why does Mandela thank the international leaders? Thanks them because they are all there to support. Naturally, they are there. That means they are supporting Nelson Mandela. They are there a part of the ceremony and they are acknowledging the new government. Yeah. What are the ideals that he has set out for the future of South Africa? What does he want? He wants equality in all spheres. He wants that. And yes, he wants to be an example to the world that such an incident never happens again. Oppression. What is oppression? What is oppression? To control someone. Yes, to show you superiority over someone. So you want that, nowhere should this happen. Everyone should be treated equally. So it was a major step in the history of South Africa and of the world also when this government was formed and apartheid was removed. Okay, yes. So we should not want that such things should happen ever, ever again. Now let's see the next part. Let's have a look. A few moments later, we all lifted our eyes in awe as a spectacular array of South African jets, helicopters, and troop carriers roared in perfect formation over the Union buildings. So as he finished his speech, after some time or a few moments later, what did he see? He saw jets. Everybody saw. And they looked towards the sky and saw these jets and helicopters and troop carriers roaring in perfect. And they're making these formation and they're flying over the building. Like we see on Republic Day. Yes, when the Republic Day parades take place and how we have the planes flying, the defense forces there, the army showing, the air force there, all the planes flying over and yes, in perfect formation. So here also they're flying over the Union buildings. It was not only a display of pinpoint precision and military force, but a demonstration of the military's loyalty to democracy, to a new government that had been freely and fairly elected. So it was not only the leaders showing their support, it was not only the international leaders, but the military of the country also showing their support to the new government, right? Only moments before, the highest generals of the South African Defence Force and police, their chests bedecked with ribbons and medals from days gone by, saluted me and pledged their loyalty. See, before the inauguration started, before the ceremony started, the big leaders here, the army generals, it all came here and they met Nelson Mandela and they were wearing the uniform and on it, the medals were there and they shook hands, they saluted and they promised their loyalty towards the new government, towards their country. And what is so surprising about it? Why does he mention this? I was not unmindful of the fact that not so many years before they would not have saluted but arrested me. So he's very surprised at how things have changed, that a few years ago, it was the same army, the same people here, they were not supporting the government. And because of the government that was there, they were arresting these people. They were not allowing them to raise their voice. But now they are there supporting him. Finally, a chevron of Impala jets left a smoke trail of the black, red, green, blue, and gold of the new South African flag. So what was a spectacular sight? Yes, what was a spectacular sight? The planes flying over. Precision means accuracy. All of them at the correct formation, at the correct time, all of them making that formation. What was the formation? It was a V formation. And as they were, you know, like, of course, flying, the smoke, it was the colors of the South African flag. So what kind of a moment was it for all the people? It was something very beautiful, something to be very proud of. And of course, making them very loyal and very proud of the new government. And yes, all of them promising to work for the betterment of the country and for the betterment of the people.